Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot, and tonight we're gonna do some science. Specifically, we're gonna do several tests on the Troodon on their venomous bite to figure out exactly how it works. There's been a lot of discussion about this online. There's been different theories and different sort of questions, and I want to get all of the information, all of the science on the venom done in this one episode. And we have four different tests we're going to do so we can figure out exactly how this venomous bite works. The first thing we want to test is whether the venom fades on its own. Now, I believe this is the case, and that if your dinosaur stops getting bitten, it won't die. It'll lose health for a little period of time and then it'll recover, but we're going to test that to be sure. So let's release our Troodon and let's release our Parasaurolophus. All the dinosaurs are default in every single way. We're using the same two dinosaurs for the entire experiment. This is proper science, ladies and gentlemen. We only want one Troodon, and we're not going to give it any food, just to incentivize its desire to bite the Parasaurolophus a little bit more. They're still very cool. I love that they use the compy noises, that real bird-like little call. So there's our para, and the idea is as soon as the Troodon bites the Parasaurolophus, we're going to separate the two out and see if the poison fades from the Parasaurolophus and at what percentage, so we can see exactly how much health the Parasaur loses from one bite before it fades. I think it's going in already. And there it is, there's the bite. So our Parasaur has been poisoned. Now what we want to do, try to separate these dinosaurs out. I need the Parasaur to move. Oh, there we go. Sorry, Troodon. It's going to be a rough day for you, but that is your new home. I am incredibly sorry. So, the Parasaur has been bitten and is now poisoned. And we're simply going to follow it for a little bit and see if it does, in fact, lose its poison status naturally over time. And there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, it is officially cured. Now, I don't know whether that was related to the population or social or not, but it is officially cured. The poison does run out over time if, at the very least, you have a happy Parasaurolophus. Your dinosaurs are not doomed to death. Now, the next experiment I want to do is testing whether the poison does, in fact, stack. Some people have mentioned this, that it seems like the poison happens faster if the dinosaur has been bitten multiple times. We're going to release a Troodon, we're going to release multiple Troodons, we're going to release a Parasaurolophus, and we're going to time the distance between each percentage point of health lost. To do that, I have to nip back quickly and time it on the other thing, though. As our Troodons and then our Parasaur are releasing, I can tell you that the default tick time for a percentage of health from Troodon poisoning is 12 seconds. It may not be 12, it may be like 12.001, but it's definitely very, very close to 12 seconds at the very least. Then obviously it would make sense for it to be a nice big round number. So 12 seconds appears to be the number to beat. Now what we need to do is try to have the Parasaur bit multiple times and then separate it from the others and again record the time between health ticks. Does the venom stack up? Does the dinosaur become more sick with more bites? That would make a lot of sense. And that would actually be really cool, because although it's not pack hunting, it would be the closest thing we have to pack hunting in the game, where multiple Troodons try to take down the same target. I think that'd be really cool. I really hope that is something we've actually got in the game. Can you get out of the way, buddy? Because she's not going to come out otherwise. Oh, they've decided to have a little chin wag instead. Fantastic. Oh. They are so much like the compies in that. They're kind of like, they're all darting together and oof, there's the first bite. I love that animation. I think that's an awesome animation. But that is only one bite, so 12% health, 1% health per 12 seconds is the current rate. I'd like to get 3 bites or so. I think that's about the necessary amount so we can actually consider this science. Second bite come again. Ugh. Okay, now. I'm going to wait for an official timing, but when she hits 96%, I'm going to time it in my head a little bit just to see if it feels like it's quicker. 1 hippopotamus, 2 hippopotamus, 3 hippopotamus, 4 hippopotamus, 5 hippopotamus, 6. That was quicker. There is no way that wasn't quicker. That was probably half the time. Yes, it's definitely ticking down faster. We don't even need to go. I'll do a little timing test on this as well, but I suspect it's been halved at the least. Now, the question is, does getting bitten again speed it up even more? And Further question, we're probably not going to cover it today, but one to think about. Does each poison have like an inherent timer? And will, let's say she got bit twice and she dropped down the 22% health or whatever it was. Would one of the poisons tick out and stop and the other continue on so she'd go back to losing 1% health every 12 seconds? Interesting to think about. I would like one more bite in the name of science. And then I'm going to block you off so you'll be absolutely safe, love. I know it kind of sucks right now. She's definitely ticking down faster. This is essentially pack hunting in a way. I do need to make sure she's fed because I don't want her to lose health because of a lack of food. Now, it appears to have slowed back down to me. This is definitely not 5 seconds. And there's the bite. That was a long one. This 84% is not dropping at all. So this is back to the 5% or so by the looks of it. 5 seconds or so, I should say. One hippopotamus, two hippopotamus, three hippopotamus, four hippopotamus. My hippopotamuses aren't perfect, to say the least. It does seem to have sped up again. It seems like the original poison faded out, like we saw, and that percentage from 84% was taking quite a long time, and now she's back to having double poisons upon her. I think we can probably call this successful science either way. The poison definitely stacks. There's really nothing more to say about that, folks. The poison definitely stacks to some extent. It speeds up the rate of poisoning, I guess. And we can move on to science 2.0. 3.0, I should say. We've done a lot of science. We're going to do even more science. And that is, can you rescue your poisoned dinosaurs by tranking them and then transporting them? I've not seen anyone mention this yet. But let's say you've accidentally released a herbivore into the middle of a Troodon pack, and before you could even get there, you know, it's stormy, you've got an Indominus Rex breaking out and eating your face on the other side. Before you can do anything else, your dinosaur gets poisoned. Can you save her just by tranking her and moving her? Will that relieve the poison? We're gonna find out. There we go! This took a really long time for some reason. I just kept releasing more Troodons into the park in order to force it to happen. I just wanted a nice little shot as well. The very slightly drunk looking Troodon going for a bite there. But there we go, nice little shot. Okay, we officially have a poisoned Parasaurolophus. It took a billion years. So we're going to trank the Parasaur. You see how many Troodons I've had to add. I've got more on the way just in case. We're going to trank the Parasaurolophus and move it over here. It gets to be happy. It gets to live with these Parasaurs over here in absolute happiness, unless it's poisoned. Even then, the poison should inherently fade over time anyway. I don't need these ones anymore. We're finally done. I don't know why it took so many of them so long to finally get a bite in, but that is the world we live in. Come on, buddy. Now, I'm not interested in whether it fades over time, because we know it does. I'm interested in purely whether the act of tranquilizing and then moving the dinosaur gets rid of that poisoning. Now, whilst we're waiting for that to happen, although it should happen nice and quickly, because there's actually a research upgrade as part of this DLC, wherein it speeds up your dinosaur moving and stuff like that. It's actually really helpful. We're going to do our final piece of science, and that is to find out whether a Troodon can poison an armored dinosaur. Now, the reason this is interesting is because the Troodon is a small carnivore, like the Dilophosaurus, the Velociraptor, blah, blah, blah. And the Velociraptor can kill a Parasaurolophus. It's got an automatic attack animation where it jumps up, loops around the head of the dinosaur, bites it, bring it down. It's a little bit unrealistic, but it's pretty cool as well. Small carnivores can kill hadrosaurs, but they can't kill armored herbivores. A Velociraptor will never kill a Triceratops. A Velociraptor will never kill an Ankylosaurus, for example. All of the armored dinosaur classification. So, we have a Triceratops and we have a Troodon. What I'm interested in is because the Troodon has an alternate attack, this poison attack, does the same thing apply? And also, as you can see, my Parasaurolophus is still poisoned. Trunking and moving the dinosaur does, in fact, not cure it. I actually thought it would, for some reason. It just seems like the kind of thing the game would do. But hey, not the case. Parasaurolophus is still poisoned. Science 3 is complete. Now, I'm going to release a bunch of Troodons in here, just to kind of speed up the process. But basically, just waiting a little while. I'm going to wait, I'll just sort of leave it running, and we'll see if our Triceratops ever gets poisoned. If it doesn't, that's pretty cool, because that means they have alternate sort of rules compared to the other small carnivores, which makes sense, because they are a small carnivore. But this makes me think it's not going to happen. Because this right here, this is what small carnivores usually do with armored herbivores. They don't attack them, but they do square up to them and have like a little dominance threatening display, which looks to be what the Troodon just did with the Triceratops. I strongly suspect the Triceratops will be fine and will not ever take damage from the Troodon. But it'd be good to check. So I'm going to give it some food, we're going to release a ton of Troodons, and we'll just see if it ever gets poisoned. Well, folks, my little Triceratops has been living with the mass number of Troodons for quite a long time now and is absolutely fine. So it does appear that, unfortunately, I think it would have been a cool little mechanic if, because of the poisonous bite, because it doesn't require direct strength like or speed like the Velociraptor, it just needs to nip. I think it would be really cool if they brought that into the game and the Troodon was capable of taking down basically anything other than, say, the sauropods and the very large carnivores. I think that might be worth looking into, because it makes a lot of sense with how the Troodon works. I've just spotted one asleep, so I want to very quickly show you that, because it's adorable. There we go. But that's about it for science. So what have we learned today, ladies and gentlemen? Let's recap our science. We have learned that poison does get removed over time. It doesn't last forever. But we've also learned that the poison does stack. If your dinosaur gets bit by two Troodons, it will die faster. And we also learned at the same time that it does appear that the poison doesn't refresh. Like, if you get poisoned once and then get poisoned a second time, the second time doesn't refresh the first poisoning. Instead, it adds on to another one. So your first one can fade and the second one will continue on. So it is possible for a dinosaur to get bit twice, but still to die at the rate of it dying once in that gap. Does that make sense? Either way, they don't refresh. They are their own instances of poisoning, basically. Their own individual debuff, as it were. Thirdly, we learned that tranquilizing and moving a dinosaur does in fact not cure it from poisoning. You do need to get it into a safe space, hope it's got enough health to survive the poisoning. You could cure it with your jeep, of course. You could replenish its health a little bit. It doesn't cure the poisoning, but it does give it more health to survive the poisoning. And finally, we learned in this rather adorable little shot here, I've got to say that looks really cool, that Troodons are incapable of poisoning armored herbivores and therefore probably large carnivores and sauropods and the like as well. Basically, they follow the exact same rules for attacking as the other small carnivores do, which is they'll attack other small carnivores and they will attack non-armored small herbivores. We got there eventually. The interesting thing about this, just a brief little thing we didn't show today, but I have shown in my playthrough, is that if a Troodon fights with a Velociraptor, for example, it's a one-to-one fight, and it loses, the raptor will still be poisoned despite winning the fight. Even if the Troodon is killed by the Velociraptor, the Troodon dies, the raptor will still be poisoned after the fact. So in theory, they could both kill each other, it just might take a little bit longer for the raptor to die. Anyways, that is Troodon Venom, how it works in the game, how the poisoning works. I hope you've enjoyed this little bit of science. I think we've covered basically everything there is to know, but feel free to ask me extra questions in the comments down below if you so choose. Thanks for joining me. We will be back with lots more content all week long. I've got loads planned for this DLC. Hope you're enjoying it. Please do hit the like button if you are. It really helps me out, guys. It's a big deal, even if it doesn't seem like it. It makes me feel all warm and fuzzy inside as well, which helps. And I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. A little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home, and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.